Howdy friends, and welcome to The Average Jay. It is Sunday morning, so today is going to be food day. We're going to have breakfast, have dinner tonight. So breakfast, I don't know, we kind of went all out. So I have scrapple, I have pork roll, scrapple and pork roll from... Well, the scrapple is not from the Amish market. The scrapple is just from the store. Pork roll, that's from the Amish market. Applewood smoked bacon, that's from the Amish market. Rye toast, it's not like beefsteak, it's actual like bakery rye. Buff Orpington eggs, woohoo! And Southwest seasoned potatoes. Going to be a big breakfast, and for dinner tonight I'm going to try Joan's recipe for horseradish Dijon. Sorry, I'm flipping the pork roll. Honey horseradish Dijon salmon. So I'm going to be trying to make that. But for right now, breakfast time. Looks like a pretty good spread. I'll show it to you on the table. Artie had not been outside to pee yet, so he had to go. But my father came over to get him, which he does most days. So, yeah, you know, not unexpected. Right. But Artie knocked all the stuff off of the counter. There were plates there. And this is the end result.
That's Corel for you.
Yeah, it's your Corel splitting. No better way to cook eggs than right on top of all that bacon grease. You know, we'll throw that all in there. Yum. As if cooking eggs in bacon grease directly isn't enough, let's throw some cheese on there. We're gonna melt some sharp cheddar cheese on there. Gonna call this breakfast the heart attack special. So this is what the table looks like. Over here we have a couple layers of scrapple. We have the pork roll, we have the rye toast. Here's the eggs cooked in bacon grease with the cheddar cheese, the Southwest potatoes, and the bacon. Pretty decent sized breakfast. Michelle loves her Taco Bell sauce on everything.
Everything.
I go with the Frank's Red Hot. I put that bleep on everything. And ketchup for the potatoes. Yay. That's breakfast. Then we'll have time to clean up. And I'll be making dinner, it seems like, quick.
Right after all this mess.
Right after this. Well, Michelle was kind enough to clean up all the busted glass and Corel plate and whatever. It is 5:15 and it is time to make dinner. So we had kind of a busy day. Not super busy, but Michelle spent a whole lot of the day cleaning. And in 3 weeks we go on vacation and I had to get the tent set up to make sure that everything was still functional and clean it out. So that's what we did. We went ahead and cleaned the tent out so that in 3 more weeks we'll be able to set up the tent with no issues down at Fort Wilderness at Walt Disney World. So we're going to make our dinner. As I said before, this is going to be a recipe that I found from Joan at Joan's Pointed Plate. I got to point out, like, my can opener for 20 some years of marriage, Michelle and I have used a hand can opener. I think we still have it. I don't know. It's probably in here somewhere, but I can't find it, but anyhow. So we decided, because it was on sale one time, to get a automatic can opener. It's a Farberware can opener. Best purchase ever. Love this thing. It's a pain sometimes to get it out of the cabinet and plug it in and all that. Like, whereas the hand one, you just, boom, there it is. But the difference that it makes in catching on and opening the can is just top notch. I will link Joan's recipe for this horseradish Dijon salmon down below. I've never tried it, so I can't say whether it's good or not good. Maybe by the end of the video, I might. I don't know whether I have a review of it or not. But regardless of whether I like it or not, I'm still going to put the recipe down below. The rest of the dinner, it's pretty simple. Green Giant kitchen slice, or no, French slice. What is it? French style. French style green beans. Woohoo! Which I use my can opener for. And Quaker grits. Not instant grits, because no self-respecting Southerner uses instant grits. Every time we make grits in the house, almost every time, we play this scene on the TV from YouTube showing grits.
What's this over here?
You never heard of grits?
Sure, I heard of grits. I used to actually never seen a grit before. Yeah, I'm gonna try it. Give it back. What is a grit, anyways?
It's made out of corn. The hominy grits.
Hominy.
We always laugh at this part, but notice when he says how it's made, they never say sugar.
How do you cook it?
Well, you simmer it in water for 15 to 20 minutes. Put it on the plate and add butter. Huh.
See, yeah, butter. Anybody who's never had grits is missing out. Like in my cousin Vinny is, he's eating grits. But Michelle still insists on putting sugar in it. It like kills me to put the sugar bowl on the table. You can say I put the sugar bowl somewhere like right there. And it kills me to put the sugar bowl on the table because, but she likes sugar on it. And the instructions are cook it for 20 minutes and add butter. It says nothing about sugar. Anywho, but we're going to have that and Pillsbury crescent rolls. So really, none of it's homemade except for the fish. I got the fish at the store this morning. And honestly, it was too early for the seafood store I normally go to. I normally go to John's Seafood in Paulsboro. But it was so early when Michelle and I went out today, we wound up just going to ShopRite in West Effort. But the salmon looked good. So we got some good, four good-looking pieces of salmon. Two I'm going to make with the horseradish Dijon. Two I will not. Brittany, do you want horseradish Dijon? Yeah, so Brittany says, no, thank you. So we're just going to make plain salmon for Brittany and Alex, but Michelle and I, we will be partaking of the sauce. But the other three things for dinner, just plain Jane. For some reason, it seems like every time I cook, Michelle wants to play with the dog. She's down on the ground playing with Artie. She was down playing with Artie at breakfast, and now she's down playing with Artie at dinner time. But I got the salmon fillets, I washed them off, patted them dry, they're sitting. I have the sauce made, I have the crescent rolls ready, the pan is ready, I just got to start heating the oil, the water for the grits is on, and the green beans are a-heating. And the table's set with like hardly anything.
Right?
We are cooking now. We have the salmon in the cast iron with the olive oil. We have the grits are boiling. Beans ain't doing squat, but that's because I have it at a very low heat. And the rolls didn't even get in yet. They're going to be in about 2 minutes. I took my first bite and it is delicious. Thank you, Joan. Love horseradish, love salmon, love Dijon. Everything worked good. Artie, you get none. Sorry. Artie was sick yesterday. He didn't feel too good. He threw up a couple times, so no human food for him. After dinner fire pit in the backyard. Just got done talking to Stephanie. Poor Gavin. He's not feeling good. He looks sick, the poor little baby. But now we are doing the fire. In a nutshell, it was a fantastic day. I think we had a good day.
Oh. A great day.
Michelle was picking up acorns. I did a lot of cooking.
Yeah.
Although, I gotta say, I did take a little nap today because I threw like right here out and it hurt really bad.
Yeah.
I've taken a lot of ibuprofen today. So, but the fire is going nice. We had a great day. The kids and I and Michelle had a nice dinner together. Thank you, Joan, at Joan's Point of Play for the recipe. It was good.
It was delicious.
Yeah, we ate good today.
For sure.
Although I don't think we ate lunch.
No, but that's okay.
No, I think breakfast was so late that we did not
wind up eating a lunch. We just ate dinner. Even though dinner wasn't all that early. It was like 6 o'clock by the time we ate.
Right? Oh, my gosh. Look at the fire.
Yeah, the fire's going nice. Whoop, whoop. But we're just going to sit by the fire. I have a cup of coffee. Michelle has a soda. And we're just going to sit out here and relax for a little while. What's that, water?
Water.
But thank you for watching. Enjoying our Sunday with us. Like, subscribe. Bye.